Welcome back to the Crypto World channel, everyone. My name is Josh, and right now the Bitcoin dominance is finding huge resistance and is currently getting a massive rejection from these levels, which means that the altcoins are gaining dominance overall. And of course, this includes Ethereum. Right now, at the time we film this video, Ethereum is pushing higher and higher. And recently we have seen some insane gains in the altcoin market. Some altcoins even reaching three-figure percentage gains in the last 1 week. And this is all due to the fact that Bitcoin is currently losing some of its dominance, and this is flowing into the altcoin market. In this video, I'll be giving you a quick update on what's happening in Ethereum. I'll also be giving you guys a quick update on Cardano, because right now Cardano has experienced a huge breakout above this incredibly important level that I've been talking about for quite a while on the channel, in fact the last few months. And we also saw a very bullish double bottom pattern for Cardano versus Bitcoin. And on top of all of that, in this video I'll be giving you guys a quick update on Chainlink, because a lot of you have been leaving suggestions in the comment section down below for me to bring back Chainlink on the channel, because the last few times that I did cover Chainlink on this channel was roughly around $15 per Chainlink when we were currently forming this falling wedge pattern for Chainlink. And I did let you guys know on the channel right there that this is a bullish pattern. We're more likely to break out to the upside. So for anyone that was on the channel just a few weeks ago and got into Chainlink as I was getting into Chainlink, once again, the gain over the past couple of weeks has been over 60% to the upside. And since the bottom just here for Chainlink, this has actually been a 100% gain in Chainlink over the past 3 weeks. Once again, 100% gain means you are doubling your money in just 3 weeks. So definitely make sure you're watching this video all the way to the end so that you're not missing out on any of this valuable information. And if that sounds good to you, just before we jump into it, make sure to leave a like on the video down below. And if you're new to the channel, you might as well subscribe to the channel with notifications turned on, because I post these updates every single day here on the channel. So you do not want to be missing out on all of these new updates that I'm giving you guys on this YouTube channel once again. But yeah, with all of that out of the way, let's get straight into what this video is about. So right here, we want the Bitcoin dominance chart on the 1 day time frame. So for the complete beginners out there, the ones that are new to this channel, the Bitcoin dominance chart basically just shows Bitcoin's market share in a percentage term against the rest of the crypto market. So for example, right now we're at roughly around 46%. So out of all of the money in the entire crypto market, roughly around 46% of it is sitting in Bitcoin. So of course, when the Bitcoin dominance is heading to the downside, that means Bitcoin's market share is going down and the altcoin's market share is going to the upside. But when the Bitcoin dominance is going to the upside, that means Bitcoin is stealing market share out of the altcoins. So basically, all you need to know with this chart just here is, generally speaking, when we are crashing to the downside, that is good for the altcoins. But when we are pumping to the upside, that is bad for the altcoins. Now, once again, there's always going to be exceptions to the rule, because there's over 10,000 altcoins out there. So there's always going to be exceptions to the rule. Once again, I want to make that clear. This just gives us a good idea on what the overall altcoin market is looking like. So for example, when the Bitcoin dominance is in this huge downtrend, that is actually an alt season, when altcoins are going crazy. Now, even though in the immediate short term, the fact that we have seen a bearish rejection from these levels just here, and even though this has actually dropped to the downside over the past couple days just recently, which has led to a lot of altcoins having some huge gains, even though that's happened, this hasn't really confirmed an alt season. I want to make that clear. Of course, this has potential to lead into an altcoin season, but once again, we really need to start breaking below some of these lower levels of support to start confirming a major alt season. Because once again, zooming out a little bit, an alt season looks like this, when we are absolutely crashing to the downside in this Bitcoin dominance chart. Our short-term supports to pay attention to is coming in at roughly around 44 to 45% right here. That was the previous low for the Bitcoin dominance. Anything below that, we do have the next lowest low coming in at roughly around 41% for the Bitcoin dominance. And bringing out the Fibonacci retracement tool, we do actually have the golden pocket coming in at roughly around 43% for the Bitcoin dominance. And of course, the resistance to the upside is the area that we did already find resistance right here in the immediate short term. And previously, we found resistance along this line. This is coming in at around 47% approximately. So once again, if this Bitcoin dominance continues to head to the downside, which by the way, is not necessarily a bearish thing for Bitcoin, I want to make that clear. The Bitcoin dominance can drop to the downside while Bitcoin can actually remain bullish against the US dollar. A prime example of this was the 2017 bull market, when when Bitcoin was absolutely shooting to the upside throughout that entire year. And yeah, by the way, this is switched to the weekly time frame for the Bitcoin dominance, showing 2017. And as you can see, the Bitcoin dominance was absolutely crashing to the downside while the Bitcoin price was pumping to the upside. This just simply meant that the altcoins were outperforming Bitcoin, that's all. And especially if we can see this weekly candle close red on the Bitcoin dominance chart, that can potentially lead into further downside for the Bitcoin dominance, which once again, in that case, will mean that the altcoins just overall on average will do pretty well. But once again, there's always exceptions to the rule. I want to make that clear. So it is always important that you're doing your own research on any altcoin that you're investing in, because that's a completely different game from just Bitcoin and Ethereum, for example. But yeah, quickly checking out the Ethereum to US dollar chart on the 1 day time frame just here. As you can see, we are still currently trading above this important red zone right here, which by the way, the top of this red zone is coming in at around $3,000 and the bottom is coming in at around 2,800. So for as long as we're remaining above that level and using that level as support, once again, that is still pretty good here in the short term. And there's really no reason to be overly bearish on Ethereum unless we start breaking below 2.8K. And if that's the case, the next support level that I'm paying attention to is coming in at roughly around 2,500, 2.4K to 2.5K is a level that we've already confirmed previous resistance. And if you're looking at 2,500, we've already confirmed that level as support just here. But when you're zooming into the shorter term, looking at the 4 hour time frame, we do actually have depleting volume and a potential bearish divergence forming in the RSI. Once again, this isn't confirmed until we can actually confirm some sort of little peak. Because for example, if the price of Ethereum continues to pump to the upside, then this will actually drag the RSI to the upside and cancel out any sort of bearish divergence that is currently forming on the chart. But we also have to consider that we are currently forming a rising wedge pattern on the 4 hour time frame. Now, once again, because this is only on the 4 hour time frame, it's not extremely significant. By the way, for the new viewers on the channel, out of every 10 rising wedge patterns that we see on the chart, roughly around 3 out of 10 break to the upside and about 7 out of 10 break to the downside. So if you're going off the stats alone, technically speaking, it's more likely to break to the downside. And if that's the case, once again, I would expect strong support coming in at this red zone just here. But yeah, essentially in the immediate short term, there is a couple little bearish signs forming. So just don't be surprised if we do have, you know, a little bit of a short-term cool off. But if anything, I myself would use that as a buying opportunity. And in terms of Ethereum price targets, they haven't really changed. We still have the golden pocket coming in at roughly around 3.3 to 3.4 thousand. We do have the golden pocket coming in at roughly around 3.4 thousand US dollars. Anything above that, of course, we have the 78.6% Fibonacci level coming in at around 3.8K, but that isn't as significant as the golden pocket. But yeah, other than those levels just there, basically just the all-time high coming in at roughly around 4,300 US dollars, give or take, and on some exchanges up towards 4,400 US dollars as the all-time high for Ethereum. That is also a very significant level of resistance for Ethereum moving forward, the all-time high coming in at around 4.4K, give or take. So yeah, those are my main price targets that I'm paying attention to and areas of support that I am paying attention to myself. Now, giving you guys a quick update on Cardano versus the US dollar. This is on the 4 hour time frame just here for Cardano. The last time I remember covering Cardano on the channel was right back here when Cardano was roughly around $1.25, give or take, when we were finally getting out of this massive resistance line just here. And by the way, this has been a huge falling wedge pattern for Cardano that we've been forming ever since around May 2021. And we only broke out in around the end of July this year, but we did find a huge resistance along this 21 week moving average. As you can see, this was actually quite significant resistance. And then it was the moment we broke above that level, we came into this exact resistance level just here. And then we came back down to the exact 21 week moving average, got a perfect bounce along that level, found a little bit more resistance in the short term at this $1.50 resistance level. And then it was as soon as we broke above this exact level that the Cardano price began to explode to the upside. Now, for the subscribers out there that have been subscribed for a few months on the channel now, I have actually been talking about the $1.50 level as a very significant level for Cardano for quite a few months now. I know that I don't cover Cardano every single day on the channel, but yeah, this $1.50 level is an important level that I've kept consistent in my Cardano updates when I do make them here on the channel, because Cardano has previously found huge resistance along that exact level in the first half of this year. And we also found another massive point of resistance along this exact level in around the beginning of July. And so once again, it was as soon as we broke above that exact level just there that we began to explode to the upside over the past couple days just recently, right up to this exact price target just here, which I did actually set for Cardano around 2 to 3 weeks ago on the channel in my last Cardano video. So once again, For those that watched my last Cardano video a few weeks ago, you would already know about this exact level that I've got on the chart. I've not actually moved this level at all because actually bringing out the Fibonacci retracement tool just here, that is actually the golden pocket, the 61.8% Fibonacci level for Cardano, currently coming in at roughly around $1.90. That's when you're drawing the Fibonacci tool from the high down to this week low just here. But if you're paying attention to the other week lows just here, then that moves the golden pocket a little bit higher up towards around $1.94. So in around that $1.90 to $2 price range just there is really our next major point of resistance for Cardano. But do keep in mind that we are incredibly overbought in the short term here, even on the daily time frame. We are incredibly overbought in the RSI here. And also on the 4 hour time frame just here, we are incredibly overbought. So we are due for a little bit of a cool off over the next few days. Once again, it's totally possible that we continue to the upside, but I would actually expect in around that $1.90 level up towards $2 as a pretty significant level of resistance to pay attention to. And just taking a look at Chainlink against the US dollar, this is on the daily time frame for Chainlink. The last few Chainlink updates that I made on this channel was right around here, roughly around 2 to 3 weeks ago. And in those exact Chainlink updates, I was letting you guys know that we are forming this massive falling wedge pattern, which is a bullish pattern, so it's more likely to break to the upside. And I was also letting you guys know that it's very likely that this exact low just here at around $13.40, give or take, that low just there is the bottom for Chainlink. Once again, I said that a few weeks ago now on the channel, and already this is playing out pretty nicely. This gain has basically doubled your money. Once again, if you bought in at the bottom just here, and for the subscribers out there, I let you guys know that that is very likely to be the bottom a few weeks ago when we were actually down at those prices. But keep in mind that the price target for a falling wedge pattern is simply the top of the wedge. Right now, that's coming in at roughly around $34, give or take. Bringing out the Fibonacci levels just here, we do actually have the 38.2% Fibonacci level coming in at around $29. So that could be a little bit of a short-term resistance level at around $29 to $30 just there. And then the golden pocket is coming in at roughly around $38 to $39 US dollars. But I could not stress this enough, make sure you do your own research as well. You should never be buying into something just because I'm talking about it on the channel. And even if I believe it is a really good investment, still make sure you're doing your own research because you never know with YouTube videos. But yeah, all in all, Chainlink is obviously in a bullish trend on the daily time frame, and also on the 4 hourly time frame, we are obviously quite clearly in a bullish trend. Chainlink usually moves in these strong surges to the upside. It doesn't have these quick pumps, it has these strong surges to the upside. So while we are still in this uptrend, that's actually what I would expect out of Chainlink moving forward. It's just a strong surge to the upside, not necessarily a massive gain extremely quickly, but once again, a pretty decent gain over time over the next few weeks. But anyway, that's just about everything I have to say for this video. There's a lot of content in this video, so I hope you all enjoyed and I hope you got something valuable out of this video. And if you did, be sure to drop a like down below. And if you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe to the channel with notifications turned on because I post these videos every single day here on the channel. So you do not want to be missing out on any of this important information. And also, if you want to be the first in the world to see these brand new videos as I'm posting them, I do actually post them straight away over on my Twitter alongside extra bonus updates throughout the day. So if you want to get extra content and real-time updates throughout the day, definitely check out my Twitter. The link to my Twitter is in the description down below. But anyway, that's just about everything I have to say for this video. Once again, I really hope you enjoyed it and I'll see you all in the next video.